The last thing that your child needs is a mom who is in a hurry for them to grow up so that she can get on with her life. And I'm saying that because I've been there. And I've reached a stage where I felt resentful about the choices that I made, and I felt held back as a woman, as a person, because of the responsibility that I had to my family. And that was a hard thing to admit, because on the surface, I would say that I love being a stay-at-home mom and I love being available to my children, and I absolutely do. But now I'm saying it from a place of greater awareness and a place of greater purpose, because I found my own awareness and my own purpose, and I did not have that before. So when you are unsure about the things that you want to do, what you want to accomplish in life, who you are, you then can become resentful about everything that you feel is standing in the way of that. And that can include your children. That can include your family. And it's uncomfortable to admit, but when you admit it, then you're now faced with this sense of discomfort, because who wants to feel like that, right? But it's a powerful place to be, because once you have confronted a giant in your life, once you have confronted what is holding you back, and that can be a feeling, it can be a mindset, it's not always a person. Once you've confronted what's holding you back, you get to fight it. You get to fight it. Fighting the mindsets that hold us back, fighting the fears, fighting the discomfort, fighting the awkwardness, that is a privilege. That is a gift. So if you are a mom and you find yourself feeling like your children are a burden, or your family is a burden, or you may be a caregiver to aging parents and it feels like a burden, and it feels like, I know I have to do this, but I don't want to do this anymore, I encourage you to find space, not find space, actually, I'm phrasing that wrong. Create space for yourself. And this may not look like you want it to look at first. It may look like 5 minutes. It may look like a good cry. Some of us have been strong for so long that we forgot how to cry. We forgot how to be vulnerable. We forgot how to break down, and we're looking for breakthrough. We're praying for breakthrough. There is no breakthrough before you break down. Understand that. Until you come honestly to yourself, you cannot come honestly to anyone else. You can't even pray honest prayers until you have reached the point where you have truly faced yourself. And it's a hard thing for some of us to do, because we have worn masks for so long. Masks of strength, masks of organization, masks of diligence, masks of being the dependable one. So we don't know what we look like. I talk about vision, I talk about goals, I talk about strategy, I talk about all kinds of different things. But at the root of it is self-awareness. Self-awareness is extremely important because without it, you're not being authentic. So your life is gonna feel like it's not yours. The very life that you created, it's gonna feel like it's not yours. Because you might have created it from a place of being who you were expected to be and not who you are. And when we do that, we run the risk of resentment. So I want to encourage you, if you're a mom who is struggling with feeling like you're stuck, it feels like the family that you love and the children that you love are a trap. That is a lie from the pit of hell. Our children are gifts. Our children are husbands. Our families are gifts for us to unwrap, to experience, to cherish. And when it comes to our children are gifts that we get to wrap and present to the world. But a woman, a mother who does not take time for herself, to care for herself, herself. And when I say herself, I don't mean the hair and the nails and the skin. I mean the woman that you are, the woman within. A woman who does not take the time to do that is a woman who's setting herself up for disappointment and for resentment. You absolutely need to know who you are. You absolutely need to be comfortable in your own skin, whether that means that you're having an amazing day or everything's falling apart. You need to be comfortable knowing who you are and where you are in that moment. And it is when you are in touch and in tune with who you are and where you are that you can show up the way that other people need you to show up. Everyone that you are afraid of disappointing needs you to be authentic. Remember that. And when you are your most authentic self, when you are in tune with yourself, when you can hear yourself clearly, when you can hear God clearly within yourself, because that's what happens when you become self-aware. You become self-aware, you also become aware of God, because he's always been in there. When you gain that awareness, you see other people better. You see your children in a better light because you're seeing yourself in a better light. So don't feel bad for feeling angry. Don't feel bad for feeling resentful even. But it's what we do with these feelings. It's how we process our thoughts. It's how we process our emotions that gets us to a healthy place where we can set goals for ourselves, for our families, for future generations. Goals that will be set in a foundation of faith and goals that will be set in a place of wholeness and healing. That's what this is all about. I hope this helps. Blessings on your journey. I will talk to you soon.